This is Duke University.
My name is Sydney Jeffs. I grew up in Durham, so very close by. Obviously, went to high school about 5 minutes away, and I just finished my major in biomedical engineering, and I also received a minor in chemistry. Yeah, I think there are a lot of little Duke experiences that make me feel like a Duke student, but in terms of my most formative academic or intellectual experience, I think I would say my research. So I started working in Dr. Jennifer West's lab. It's a biomaterials and biofunctional materials lab, and I started that the spring of my freshman year, so pretty early, and I've since completed 6 semesters of independent study, and then in my junior year also started a Pratt fellowship. So I've been pretty heavily involved in research, and that's been a really awesome way for me to grow, as I said, as academically, but also through mentorship. I had a really close relationship with my faculty advisor, Dr. West, as well as the various graduate students in the lab, so that was a really awesome way for me to get involved in BME in a different way. So to see where Duke is headed as a research university as well was really cool for me. So about halfway through, I decided that medical school was something I might be interested in. And as I mentioned, I had a really strong interest in research, and I had an established interest there. And so then it sort of became, okay, maybe I want to do an MD PhD program. And to do that, I started a little bit later on that process. So I took my MCAT this past semester, and that gives me a little bit of time now after I graduate. So I'll be applying starting in June and spending the whole year applying. And also during that process, I'll be working in Boston doing research. It's a tissue engineering lab, so they do really cool work there. It's a part of Mass General Hospital. So I'll be there for the year while also applying. And then after that, hopefully going to an MD PhD program. Yeah, I think sometimes it's hard to see that when you're in the moment, when you're taking a lot of classes, but I had a really cool experience this, my very last semester taking a course. It was, the number was BME 590, and I think it was advanced topics in biomaterials, I'm not exactly sure. And that was actually taught by Dr. West, who is my research advisor, and that probably lended itself to being a really good experience, but it was the first time that I was sort of given free rein on homework assignments. So for example, we'd be asked, you know, design a novel biomaterial for use in a vascular graft, or design a new hip implant. And at first you think like, oh, I can't do that. I don't have the experience for that. And then you start writing the paper. And by the end of it, I felt, okay, I can really do this. I have the tools to approach these topics. It's been something that my interviewers have really loved hearing about, my ability to problem solve. I think it really showed me, BME has given me a lot of tools, a lot of thinking styles. So I think really the biggest thing that I've gotten is the way I approach problems, I think is really unique as an engineer compared to some of my friends, the way that I take a problem and start, you know, developing my own solution to that. So that was very cool. I think BME was extremely significant in shaping that aspect. So towards the end of my high school career, as I was applying to colleges, is when I first started to consider engineering, and specifically BME. And I had the chance to speak to a dean on campus, which you don't have to do, but I luckily did. And they basically told me, look, if you're considering engineering and you think you might have an aptitude for it, just go ahead and start in Pratt. You'll get into engineering right away, it'll be all around you, and you'll get a really strong sense of whether you like it or not. And in doing that, I think I took a really big risk on myself and risk in trying something new, a little bit outside of my comfort zone. And I think that taking risks is something that you should keep at the back of your mind throughout your college experience. And in another way, when you're in a class, if you start thinking like, oh, this sounds really cool, or professor's research sounds really interesting, don't just let that thought pass you by and put it in the back of your mind, but really pursue that and say, okay, like, how can I pursue this more, or how can I use the resources at the foundry or the research labs or independent study to keep doing that, pursuing that sort of interest that you have.
This is Duke University.